Are Studio 3 approaches effective on larger children or adults? It's a question I'm asked all the time. I've spent about 30 years of my career trying to explain to people over and over again that actually it's not about your physical size and presence. It's about how calm you remain in crisis situations that communicates that information to another person. Laying hands on someone and physically managing someone should be the ultimate last resort. But it's very difficult when people listen to the ideas that we talk about and they suddenly reflect on their own thoughts and feelings. I have restrained people in the past. I'm not proud of it. It's something I got out of the habit of doing, and it wasn't because I was promoted in some clinical psychologist behind some office desk. It's because I chose not to do that anymore. I started to understand that the methods I was taught in the 80s were actually not appropriate. I don't even think they were appropriate for the 1980s, to be perfectly honest. So this culmination ideas about our approach and how practical it is, actually it's far more practical to give someone space when they're upset, to allow them to escape into other situations. These are practical things that you can do. The physical things that we would teach on training courses are about keeping yourself free from injury, but not injuring that other person. So to me, when people ask the question, does your stuff, as somebody said to me this recently, work with bigger people? The answer is of course. What people don't seem to understand is this is not about a what if scenario. Would your stuff work with someone who's 10 foot tall and psychotic? They're actually not the right questions. The real question is, can you train people to be better at crisis management and respect people and be calm in that moment of crisis without necessarily overly laying on hands? And the answer is yes.